Wasting no time, Pontius accepted Rosabelle's offer for dinner. While their hostess retired for the night, the heroes gathered their strength. Soon they left the eerie house. The hour was late, but the quest urged them on.
It's better to travel on a full stomach. What a fine lady this Rosabelle is.
I thought she was rather beautiful. For an older woman.
More so than your wife?
Oh, she must be sick with worry. Or very angry. Probably both.
Is that
not a daisy?
Something is very wrong with this forest.
Those tiny lights!
Haven't you seen fireflies before? They're attracted to light.
Thank you.
Don't feel right.
You should have eaten more than an apple for dinner.
No, it's this forest. It's somehow dark.
That's because it's way past midnight.
The pit is full of those monster plants.
Close your eyes and imagine their hyacinths. Izzy, happy birthday and thank you for the roses. I went to bed early. You've so many dancing partners to choose from. I think your feet will be quite sore tomorrow, Rosabel.
This must be the cave Rosabel mentioned. It should lead us to the castle.
As the heroes moved beyond the dark grove, their hearts felt uplifted. According to Rosabel, the swiftest way to the castle went through the cavernous tunnels. The path led down to the underbelly of the forest.
Oh, you haven't encountered any more of those talking flowers? I guess we were meant to find Rosabel.
Uh-huh. This statue looks a little like Amadeus's wife when she gets cross.
Oh, I think you're right.
Hmm. What do these creatures eat?
There must be something in the water here. Or maybe it's in the soil.
Can't wait to find out what.
Okay.
Perhaps there was something up above they had overlooked.
Dear Rosie, I'm so sorry I didn't notice you leaving the party. Happy 16th, my love. Let's go to the forest tomorrow through the secret cavern. Isabel.